how all these grease systems are going to work. Okay, so answer for this question is all solar power systems work on the same basic principle. Okay, it must be very clear in your mind that all solar power system work on the same basic principle. And what is this basic principle? Solar panel first convert solar energy or sunlight into DC power, okay, using what is known as the photovoltaic effect. Fine. Then the DC power can be stored in a battery or converted by a solar inverter into AC power. Fine. Which can be used to run home appliances. Depending on the type of system, excess solar energy can also be fed into the electricity grid to provide credits and further reduce electricity cost. Fine. So this is the basic principle on which every type of solar power system works. Means the working principle for all the solar power based system are same, whether it is on grid or off grid or hybrid system. Fine. So what is the basic principle? Again, I am telling what is the basic principle behind running all these solar power based systems. What they do? Solar panel first converts solar energy or sunlight into DC power. Fine. Using what is known as the photovoltaic effect. Afterwards, what happens? The DC power can then be stored in a battery or converted by a solar inverter into AC power, which can be used to run home appliances or anything which you want to, which is desired by the consumer side. Okay. And depending on the type of system, excess solar energy can also be fed into the electricity grid to provide credits and further reduce your electricity cost. Fine. Is it clear to all of you? Now, the second thing is that there are three main types of solar power system. As I have discussed earlier, they are on-grid, off-grid, and hybrid. That you have to use according to your choices or according to your need. So first of all, you must know what is this on-grid system. This on-grid system is also known as a grid tie or grid-fed solar system. Fine. First one is the on-grid system. This on-grid system is also known as a grid tie or grid-fed solar system. Okay. And off-grid system, it is also known as a standalone power system, that is SAPS. Okay, if someone is asking you what do you mean by SAPS, okay, then what will be your answer? SAPS means standalone power system, and it is used in your off-grid system. And the third one is your hybrid system. Hybrid system, what happens in this one? On-grid plus off-grid. Both of the mode can be implemented in this hybrid system. And apart from solar, any another type of renewable energy can also be tied up in this hybrid one. So we can say that solar plus battery storage with grid connection happens in the case of hybrid. Okay. So now all of you have to know what is the main components of a solar system, solar panels. Okay. Then we will come to on-grid, how your on-grid mode is going to work, how your off-grid mode is going to work, and how your hybrid mode is going to work. And behind all these three modes, the prime culprit or prime parameter is your solar photovoltaic cell. Fine. So first of all, you have to know what are the main components of a solar system, solar panels. Okay. So as most of you are aware, most modern solar panels are made up of many silicon based photovoltaic or PV cells, okay, which generate direct current electricity from solar energy. And afterwards, the individual PV cells are linked together within the solar panel and connected to adjacent panels using DC cable. Fine. And it should be noted by all of you, it is a light energy or iridescence, not heat, which produces electricity in photovoltaic cell. and solar panel, also known as solar modules, are installed together in strings to create a what is known as a solar array. So is it clear to all of you? What do you mean by solar array? Array ka matlab samajh mein aa raha hai? Say yes or no. None of you are responding. And the amount of solar energy generated depends upon a number of factors, including the orientation, the tilt angle of the solar panels, efficiency of the solar panels. So question may be asked, okay? Write down the question. Amount of solar energy generated on what factors? Okay, so your answer may be the amount of solar energy generated depends on a number of factors, and they are orientation and tilt angle of the solar panels, second one, efficiency of the solar panel, plus any losses due to shading, dirt, and even ambient temperature. Fine. So there are many different solar panel manufacturers on the market, so it is worth knowing which are the best solar panels and why. Now you have to go for the solar panels. In this mode, I am not going to speak a lot of things. Only you have to know what is solar panels, the main components of solar panels, and what are solar arrays. Okay. So different type of solar panels are available in the market that I am not going to describe. Okay. Depending upon your necessity and your choice, you have to choose the required solar panels. Fine. And for choosing behind the solar panels, a lot of parameters are required, which I am not going to discuss in this section. Okay. So what happens? The solar panels can generate energy during cloudy and overcast weather, but the amount of energy depends on the thickness and height of the clouds, which determines how much dispersed light can pass through. Okay. And the amount of light energy is known as solar irradiance, and usually averaged over the whole day using the term peak sun hours. This term has been already described by me in the previous classes regarding solar radiation. Okay, when you will get the maximum hour of solar radiation? Anyone can answer? When you will get the maximum amount of solar radiation? Nishant, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. You are audible, ma'am.
Yeah, no one is giving the response. I'm asking when you are going to get the maximum amount of solar radiation throughout the day. कब मिलेगा आपको ज़्यादा radiation?
Ma'am, noon time.
Yeah, noon time means most probably at 12 noon. Fine, the correct answer. Why? Why you will get the maximum solar radiation at the noon time? What is the basic logic behind it?
Because, ma'am, the sun hits the panel directly with the 90 degree.
Yeah, it's correct. Who is there? What's your name?
My name is Akshay Kumar Prajapati.
Yeah, you're very much correct. Okay. So next thing which I has to describe, what happens in your off-grid system, what happens in your on-grid system, and what happens in your microgrid system. Okay, so what happens in your off-grid system? This system work independently of the grid, but have batteries which can store the solar power generated by the system. Okay, kya hota hai aapka off-grid system mein? It work independently of the grid, but have batteries which can store the solar power generated by the system. And this system usually consists of solar panels, battery, charger, grid.
Ma'am, it got unmuted. Hello? Hello? The device got muted, ma'am.
Nishant, am I?
Ma'am, your device is still on mute.
Now, is it okay? Nishant?
Hi, yes, ma'am.
Now it's fine?
Hi, yes, ma'am. It's okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Now we are sorting.
In between, what is happening? I'm not able to get. Okay. So we were talking about. Now it's audible, na? Nishant?
Yes, ma'am. It's audible. It's clearly audible, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, it's clearly audible.
So I was. Okay, fine. Thank you, Nishant. So I was talking about off-grid system. So what is this off-grid system? This off-grid system is that it works independently of the grid, okay? But have batteries can store the solar power independently work consideration, okay? And that consideration are, it is usually consist of solar panels, battery, charge controller, grid box, inverter, mounting structure, and balance of system. Okay. So actually what happens in the system? The panel store enough sunlight during the day and use the excess power generated in the night. Fine. Kya karta aapka ye system? दिन भर चार्ज होता है और एक्सेस पावर को यूज करता है रात में एंड दिस सिस्टम आर सेल्फ सस्टेनिंग एंड प्रोवाइड पावर फॉर क्रिटिकल लोड्स इन एरियाज वेयर ए पावर ग्रिड इज नॉट अवेलेबल फाइन दिस इज अबाउट योर ऑफ ग्रिड सिस्टम एंड यू मस्ट नो वेयर दिस ऑफ ग्रिड सिस्टम विल बी यूज वेयर इट विल बी बेस्ट सुटेड means you have to know about the application of off-grid system. So what will be your answer regarding this application of off-grid system? Nishant, I am audible, na?
Yes, ma'am.
So the best application of this off-grid system, you can say that electricity supply in rural and remote areas. Try to correlate this point to your home. Last classes, we have just instructed all of you to go to just have a small grid project. Okay, I have discussed with all of you that you have to just make a small project, mini project on this grid system. Okay, so just keep in mind which type of grid you will choose for that one. Okay. In the last session, I will ask you. Fine. So, what will be the best application for your off-grid system? We can say that electricity supply in rural and remote areas. Okay. Off-grid solar system can facilitate independent, long-term, and sustainable electricity generation in rural and remote areas. Now, the question is how? Try to get it. All this. Questions should be answered by all of you because whatever I am discussing, they are directly or indirectly related to the questions. Okay, and in that description only you will get the answer of all the questions. Fine. So what happens in these areas? Power backup in areas with where the first point regarding the application of this off-grid system, I told ki electric it can be used in rural and remote areas. Now you have to find out how you will use this off-grid system or how you are going to implement this off-grid system in rural and remote areas. Fine. The second point regarding the application of off-grid is power backup in areas where frequent electrical cuts are there. Fine. A number of places in India is always facing frequent power cuts due to power transmission malfunctions, which can hamper orientation of companies and public institutions. Fine. So off-grid solar system can provide an economical and viable backup solution to overcome the problem. It's all about your off-grid system. What are the application of off-grid system and how you are going to implement the off-grid system, that you have to think about it. Okay, now come to on-grid power system. Fine. What is this on-grid power system? Just reversal of your off-grid power system. What happens in this system? In on-grid solar power system, it generates power using a solar power system and are directly connected to the utility power grid. What does it mean? This system sends excess power generated by the solar power system to the utility grid, and consumers get compensated for the extra power feedback. Okay? And these systems are not going to work independently. So this system works in collaboration with the power grid. What happens in this case? In the case whether there is not enough sunlight to meet your business need, the system runs on the power supplied by the grids. Fine. And these systems are best suitable when your power consumption is high and you wish to reduce your electricity bills. Fine. So basically this happens in case of your on-grid solar power system. Now you must be aware what are the advantages of your on-grid system. The advantages of your on-grid systems are: on-grid systems are very cost effective and easy to install. Now come to the point. How I am telling your on-grid solar systems are very cost effective and easy to install is the off-grid system is not cost effective and easy to install. Compare these points for on-grid and off-grid. Okay. As I have told, for the application of off-grid, ki humko usko remote area mein lagana hai. रिमोट एरिया में अगर कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव नहीं होगा तो कैसे लगाएंगे. ठीक है, दिस पॉइंट शुड बी नोटेड बाय ऑल ऑफ यू. ओके, नाउ द अनदर एडवांटेजेस रिलेटेड टू दिस ऑन ग्रिड सोलर पावर सिस्टम इज बिजनेस कैन रिकूप द कॉस्ट ऑफ देयर इन्वेस्टमेंट बाय नो दिस पॉइंट शुड नॉट बी डिस्कस विथ ऑल ऑफ यू. थोड़ा ये हो जाएगा. ठीक है, लीव इट. नाउ टेल मी, suppose that you have to just write a mini project. Okay, you have to write a mini project regarding this green energy. In which mode you will write it? Give the answer of my question, then I will go ahead. Aapko ek chhota sa mini project banana hai aur aapko kaha ja raha hai ki aap aapke aas paas mein ek chhota sa koi gaon hai, 10 ghar ka koi gaon hai. Okay, 10 houses contains that village. And in that village, there is no frequent power supply. Okay, in the lean period, in the maximum in the night time, 6 to 9, the villagers are not getting sufficient power. A lot of power cuts are there during that period. So you have to just do something for that poor villagers. What you will do, being a technocrat? Bataiye. क्या करेंगे? टेल मी, आई नीड सम आंसर. अक्षित, आर यू देयर? हेलो.
यस मैम, आई एम देयर. हेलो. यस मैम, आई एम देयर.
Okay, so then you have to conclude. Okay, next part will be concluded by you. I will get tell you to join the session. Okay, participant, anybody? No one speaking anything. Means it. Chalo, leave it. Then coming to the hybrid one. Hybrid kya hota hai? Sab cheez ko mila jula ke chalne wala. So means it will be the combination of on grid and off grid, is known as hybrid tied solar system. So now there are three type of grid tied solar system with you. According to your choice, you have to use it. Okay, in my question, which type of grid tied solar system you are going to use? None of you are giving any responses. Fine. But the main point which should be noted by all of you, that in our country, electricity consumption in our country is forecasted to reach electricity consumption in India is forecasted to set a target of reaching 22 gigawatt by 2022. Okay, and is offering a number of benefits as well as tax rebates to businesses which shift to renewable energy system. सब चीज कह रहा है कि renewable energy system से किया जाएगा because हमारा demand बढ़ता जा रहा है and government is just motivating us to switch on in renewable energy based system. And among all the system, they are just motivating us to go through the solar energy system. Why? Because the first point which should be noted by all of you, solar power systems are a source of clean renewable energy and have numerous benefits depending on the system you choose. Okay, and the second point which we can go through is that these days we are able to see that there is a drop in the prices of solar PV in the last few years. Okay, and government is also having significant policy level implementation by our government of India, setting up solar PV technology system in residential buildings and business organization. Fine. So question which can be for you, how your off-grid system is going to work. Okay, that answer you can give with the help of whatever I have presented, asked to all of you, and you are not giving any option. Okay, so with these words, I am just inviting Akshit to tell something regarding all this. Please come and join the session.
Hello.
Yeah, good Akshit, please come and join. Yeah.
Good evening to all. Yes, Namrata ma'am has told you about off-grid and on-grid projects, power system projects and hybrid solar system projects. So it is very urgent to use renewable energy sources for production of electricity. So government are also giving support in providing incentives. So how many of you are from Bihar? Anybody from Bihar?
Hello. I'm not responding at all. Please respond.
Anybody from Bihar?
Yes, sir. Hello.
How many are from Bihar? Hello.
They are responding. Yes, Chandradeep, we can see.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Or you can write in the chat, how many are from Bihar?
Okay, actually, I am also from Bihar. You can carry on.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
They are not replying.
Bihar government, okay, is providing incentive for. They have actually came up with a plan of rooftop solar project, wherein residential colonies and residential homes can install a rooftop project, and government is providing incentive. So the cost is coming around 49,000 or 50,000 for installing a project up to 3 kilowatt. So 65% incentive is being given by the government. So government will be giving 32,000, and you have to only use 17,000 from your pocket to install a solar project. So there are number of benefits in terms of years if you'll be using for a long time, you will be saving around 1,50,000 or 1,60,000. So this is a project by Bihar government. So they have introduced a new project wherein you can use a rooftop solar project at your homes. So government are providing incentives and providing supports also for implementing these renewable energy projects. So basically yesterday we have seen that for designing a reliable and efficient home solar electric system, there are certain components. So can anybody name the components of a solar home electric system? Ma'am has also told about the components. Anybody, any one of you?
Please speak something.
What are the components that we can use in a home solar electric system?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Sir, we can use solar panels, inverters, battery, and some mounting structure to hold the panel.
Okay. So basically, we have three components. The first one is photovoltaic panels, solar panels. Second is a battery, and third is a inverter. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now to design the system, we know that we need certain inputs. So the inputs will be the solar radiation. We need to know about the solar radiation of the particular place where you are installing the system. So in designing a system, first we have to see what is the load that we have to serve. Considering a house, as yesterday I have shown you that the table wherein we can calculate the number of loads depending on the appliances we have used. So the first part will be the number of the estimation of load at the residential complex that you are using your system. Okay, so yesterday I have told about the load estimation part, wherein you can calculate the total watt hour that is needed for your home, for your system. And the second part, hello.
It's audible.
First we have to calculate the power consumption demand that we are having in our house. So the total watt hours per day of each appliances are calculated. Now the second part will be to calculate the watt hours needed from the PV modules or PV panels. So as we yesterday I have told you one formula wherein total watt hours per day needed from the PV panels is equals to 1.3 times the total watt hours per day required by the appliances. So this 1.3 times is actually due to energy lost in transmitting the power or converting the power from DC to AC. So this 1.3 is a safety factor you can consider depending upon the situation. So 1.3 to 1.6 or 1.7 is good. So the second part and the third part will be the sizing the PV modules. So different size of PV modules will produce different amount of powers. Okay, consider a 40 watt of a panel. So if you need 240 watt power for your appliances and you have a solar panel of 40 watt, you can connect it in a series of 6 to get that power. Considering the safety factor, you can take 7 PV modules, so it comes out to be around 280 watt. So this factor should be taken by designing a system. So the number of PV modules is equals to the total watt hours per needed from the PV modules into a factor, and that factor can be around 3.43 or 3.5, 3.4, 3.8 to 4. So it will be coming around 3 to 4 this factor, and this depend upon the location where you are using your PV modules. As you know that power will be dependent upon the solar radiation, so area where solar radiation is more, you will need less PV modules, and in the area where the solar radiation is quite less, we will have to use more number of PV modules. So this factor is to show the dependence on the climate, because the power will be different in different conditions. So now the next part will be total what peak hour rating needed from the PV modules. Now the peak power is, like I have told you, a panel wherein it can supply a maximum power of 40 watt. In the same way, consider a home at a location where is your load is at the peak. Consider the time in the evening hours wherein you have switched on the lights, the fans, somehow ACs also. So the consumption at the evening time is quite more. So at that point, we need a peak rating or peak watt. So this is also decided for the PV modules. So the total total watt peak is dependent on the load. So consider if you have a load of around 1 kilowatt, you can use 200 watt of a maximum power PV module and connect 5 in a series. So this is how you can use number of panels depending on the load and the maximum power rating of PV panels that you are having. Okay. Now the inverter part, how you have to connect the inverter or what will be the size of the inverter. So depending upon the losses that occur in our system, electrical losses, so inverter should be designed such that it should be able to handle 20 to 25% of more powers that has been required by the appliances. So consider like you have a peak rating of 1000 watt at your house. So you should design you should use the inverter of 1250 watt to consider the effect of the losses also. Okay, so the three parts we have done, what is that? The PV modules part and the inverter part. Now the battery part, we have to consider a battery part. Now the in designing the in sizing the battery, we have to consider certain steps. So first one will be calculating the total watt hours per day used by the appliances, as you have considered in the case of PV. Now the second part will be, you have to consider the losses also. So you have to divide that total watt hours per day needed by the appliances divided by 0.85 or 0.9, you can consider that 0.85 or 0.9 is the efficiency of the battery conversion. So it is around 0.85 to 0.9. And the third step will be, see, in a battery we cannot use a battery to its maximum position. We cannot charge it to 100% and discharge it to 200%, because it will degrade the performance of the battery in the long term, longer time of frame. So we are designing a system such that we will not be operating the battery at its maximum usage. We will limit the usage to 80% only, or 60%, depending on the usage you want, or depending on the degradation of the battery, because the lifetime of the battery will be decreased if you are using it to the full extent. Any appliances, if you are using it to the full extent, it will degrade its lifetime. So to consider the effect of future lifetime also, we can divide it to a factor which is known as the state of charge. So a state of charge 0.6 to 0.8 can be taken as a state of charge. So we will dividing the total watt hours by 0.85 to consider the losses and 0.6 to consider the effect of long-term effects. Okay, now the fourth part is, we have to consider a battery voltage. The battery capacity should be in ampere hour, and the calculation that we are doing in watts. So, and the capacity of the battery is in ampere hour, so we have to divide it by the voltage part. So the nominal battery voltage that we are using in our system is around 12 volt or 24 volt. Basically a 12 volt battery system is normally used. So dividing the total watt hours that we have calculated by 0.85 and then 0.06 to show the discharge or to show the effect of long term, and then we have to divide it by the battery voltage. So now the battery ampere hour capacity can be written as, you can write down the formula. battery capacity in ampere hour is equals to total watt hours per day, total watt hours per day used by appliances divided by 0.85, or you can write efficiency of battery. I'm giving you these values because these values are generally used in the research purpose, and many authors have used these values. Okay, in a generalized purpose, you can write 0.85 as the efficiency of a battery, and so total watt hours per day used by appliances divided by 0.85 into 0.6. Now this 0.6 represents the depth of the discharge, and it is totally dependent on the user. If you want to use your battery system for a longer frame of time, you should be using your depth of discharge in the range of 0.6 to 0.8. And 0.85 into 0.6 into 0.6 into battery voltage. Into battery voltage. This is the normal ampere hour capacity for a day. Okay, so I'm repeating the formula. Battery capacity in ampere hour for a day is equals to total watt hour per day needed by appliances divided by efficiency of the battery into depth of discharge into battery voltage. So this is the battery capacity for a particular day. Now consider a situation wherein you are having a rainy condition outside for 2 or 3 days or 5 days maximum. So in that case, solar will not be able to generate the electricity. It will be able to generate a small amount of electricity, which will be a really small quantity amount. So in that case, your battery should be able to operate during that hour. So we should consider the capacity of the battery to such that it can run the system for at least a quite number of days, and the number of days are dependent on the user. So as you know that if we increase the battery capacity, the cost will also increase. So the trade-off should be taken in between the number of autonomy days that you are taking and the cost of the system. So basically, for the number of days a battery can operate in case the solar energy is not there is considered as 3 to 4 days. So a battery capacity that you will be needed for your whole system is the battery capacity needed for one day into the days of autonomy. Days of autonomy represents wherein solar is not able to provide you the required energy. Okay, so this is all about the battery system. Now consider one part where I have told you the depth discharge. So in case the solar is producing an excess energy, so that excess energy will be taken by the battery. So battery will be charging itself, and in this process of charging, after coming to 60% of total capacity, so what will happen? We will not be able to charge it more, because charging and discharging it more will have an effect on the long term operation of the battery. So we should have one controller type of thing that can switch it on or switch it off in case we need power, or in case we want to end up the charging cycle or the discharging cycle. Okay, so one more component we need, that is solar charge controller. So solar charge controller, basically it controls the operation of the battery to handle the current from the PV system or the PV panels. And it is also useful in providing the in preventing the overcharging of the battery, and the battery lifetime is increased. So for a solar charge controller, rating should be equals to the total short circuit current of PV array into 1.3 times. This 1.3 times is usually taken as a factor to consider the losses of the system. So we have a brief idea of how to design a solar system or solar home solar electric system depending on the load profile and the power. So I'm giving you an example. Consider a house. You can write the example and you should calculate out what the ratings are coming for all. Okay, so write the question. A house has following appliances. So the number one is 118 watt CFL, which is used for 4 hours per day. Now the second appliance is a fan of 60 watt, which is used for 2 hours per day. I'm giving you just an example. And you have one refrigerator. Hello.
Yes, Akshay. You are audible.
Hello.
Refrigerator. Hello.
Yeah, Akshay. It's audible. Hello. Yeah, Akshay.
Yes.
It's audible. Yeah. Are you listening to me, Nishant?
Yes. Yeah. Actually, there is a question from student. He is asking about the fan rating. It's a 60 watt for 2 hours.
Yeah. 60 watt for 2 hours.
Sir, will you please repeat the question from starting?
Okay. A house, consider a house which has the following electrical appliances . So the first appliance is 18 watt CFL. Which runs for 4 hours per day. Now the second one is a fan of 60 watt which runs 2 hours a day. Now one refrigerator of 75 watt which runs for 12 hours a day. So now I'm giving you a situation wherein I'm considering a battery of a voltage 12 volt, and we have PV panel of rating 110 watt. Now design a system, a solar electric system, to determine the number of PV panels comma battery capacity needed and the size of the inverter. Okay. Can you all calculate? So what will be the total appliances usage per day? What are the total watt hours needed by the appliance per day? It is not watt. Watt hours per day.
Watt hours per day.
Units का बहुत ध्यान रखना है. Units अगर गलती हो गई तो फिर पूरा गलत है. This is energy. Okay?
Yes.
Because you are multiplying it with the time. So this is so the total appliance usage coming out to be 1092 watt hours per day. Okay? Now, what will be the total amount of energy needed from the PV panels? Considering the effect of losses.
So 2400 watt per day.
How you have calculated 2400 per day?
Sir, I have multiplied by 1.25, or I have changed. I have multiplied 1.25 from the 197020.
1092.
Yes, sir. Actually, that one 1920. I have multiplied as you have said in the previous.
No, you are multiplying it same, but you are multiplying the wrong value. 1092 is watt hour per day needed. You are multiplying 1920.
Okay.
1092, it is 1092 watt hours per day.
Okay.
Calculate that. See, the total appliances usage will be 18 watt into 4 for the CFL plus 60 watt of fan into 2 for it is for 2 hours plus 75 into 12. Okay, so it is coming around come equal to 1092 watt hours per day. Okay,
yes.
So the total amount of energy needed from the PV panels is
1365 watt per day.
1365 वॉट आवर्स पर डे वॉट नहीं वॉट आवर्स पर डे
वॉट आवर्स पर डे
सर कितना से मल्टीप्लाई करने बोले आप 1092 को
1092 को देखो 1.3 1.2 टू 1.6 की रेंज में ले सकते हो ठीक है लॉसेस के हिसाब से जितने ज्यादा लॉसेस रहेगा उतना ज्यादा जैसे वायर्स यूज किए हैं ठीक है वायर्स में लॉसेस होंगे सिस्टम में लॉसेस होगा तो उसको कंसिडर करके 1.3 ले लो 1.3 से मल्टीप्लाई कर लो
ओके
तो 1.3 से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे कितना आएगा is coming around
1420
watt hours per day okay now this is the maximum capacity we will be needing from the solar panels now what will be the total maximum power rating of a PV panel maximum power rating this is the watt hour for a day
Sir, what is maximum means what we have to calculate?
The peak power.
Peak power means, sir, how much the battery required from the how much capacity, how much water battery is required for the
battery, PV panel. See,
for the PV.
एक फैन का समझो तुम, ठीक है ना, या फिर अपना फ्रिज का समझो, उसकी हर चीज़ की एक मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी होती है, ठीक है, वॉट के हिसाब से। जैसे तुम तो फैन देखते हो, फैन की मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी लिखी रहती है 60 वॉट या 100 वॉट, 100 वॉट, लेकिन ज़रूरी नहीं है कि वो 100 वॉट पे काम करे, हो सकता है कि सिचुएशन ऐसी है वो 60 वॉट पे भी काम करे, लेकिन उसकी मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी कितनी है देने की, 100 वॉट, 100 वॉट, ठीक है ना। वैसे ही हम लोग को चाहिए है कितना, 1420, ठीक है, तो इसको सप्लाई करने के लिए हम लोग को कितना, हम लोग को मतलब कितना मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी का पैनल हम लोग को चाहिए होगा, समझे बात को। कितना आ रहा है इसका,
सर 2400 वॉट आवर पर डे। सर
2400 कैसे आ गया,
यू टोल्ड दैट इट
टोटल वॉट पावर पीवी कैपेसिटी रेटिंग इज इक्वल टू वॉट, टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी नीडेड फ्रॉम द पीवी पैनल्स डिवाइडेड बाय द फैक्टर प्लांट जनरेशन फैक्टर व्हिच इज 3.4 टू 3.6।
ओहो आई हैव डेटा।
कैलकुलेटर नहीं तुम लोग के पास, कितना आ रहा है, कितना आ रहा है,
560.26 वॉट ब्राउन कुमार
560.04 इससे डिवाइड किया है, 1420 डिवाइडेड बाई 3.4
सर इट विल बी 417.6।
417.6, ठीक है, वॉट, ये हो गया हम लोग का वॉट, ठीक है ना, इतना वॉट हम लोग को मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी चाहिए होगी पीवी पैनल की, ठीक है। नाउ अब कितने नंबर ऑफ पीवी पैनल चाहिए होंगे, एक हम लोग के पास है 110 वॉट का, ठीक है, हम लोग को चाहिए है 416, तो हम लोग को कितने पैनल्स लगाने पड़ेंगे, चार पैनल लगाएंगे तो काम नहीं होगा, 400 ही हो पाएगा, सो यू हैव टू कनेक्ट 5 पैनल्स। ओके,
सर यहाँ पर लिखा हुआ है कि पीवी पैनल का रेटिंग 110 वाट है, तो हम जो आया 417 वाट आया, वाट आवर आया,
वॉट आवर नहीं, वॉट आया, वॉट वो मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी है जो तुमको चाहिए
हाँ
होगी,
हाँ
ठीक है।
तो मैक्सिमम तो 5 ही लगा सकते हैं ना।
हाँ, 5, 4 लगाने से कम हो जाएगा, 4 लगाने से क्या हो जाएगा, 400 वॉट तक आएगा, 417 कवर नहीं हो पाएगा पूरा, ठीक है। कितने लगाएंगे? फाइव मॉड्यूल्स, मतलब हम लोग को इंटीजर वैल्यूज में लेना है टू बी प्रिसाइज, ठीक है, क्योंकि पैनल्स हम लोग आधा और पौना नहीं लगा सकते, ठीक है ना? तो वी हैव टू टेक इंटीजर वैल्यूज.
Akshay, just tell them they will practice some numerical based upon that. So at least they will have the idea.
No, अपने घर का ही कर सकते हैं, अपने घर का ही एक example लेके कि कितना है, अपना ही बना सकते हैं अपने घर का. सर example बता दिया कि एक example दे दिया, इतने fan हैं, अब अपने हिसाब से लोग.
They can modify it.
हाँ, they can modify. बस एक छोटा सा example दे दिया मैम कि अपने हिसाब घर के हिसाब से even design.
It's good.
All of you got it? किसी को कोई दिक्कत हो तो पूछ लो एक बार.
Anyone is having any doubt in this segment may ask.
कोई दिक्कत है तो पूछ लो अभी भी.
हेलो हेलो.
यस ज्वेल, वी आर एबल.
सर माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट मैक्सिमम पावर ऑफ पीवी इज 417.641.
हां, यस यस.
पावर पैनल ऑपरेटिंग 110 वाट.
हां,
वाई 5 4 वाई 4
टोटल इज कमिंग अराउंड 417, ठीक है. अगर हम लोग चार यूज करेंगे तो कितना आएगा? 440 का, ठीक है. लेकिन फिर भी मतलब होता नहीं है कि थोड़ा सा एक्सटेंशन लेना जरूरी है, हल्का सा, ठीक है, क्योंकि अभी हम लोग का एस्टिमेशन, दिस इज द प्लानिंग पार्ट, ठीक है.
सर, हाउ मच एक्सटेंशन वी शुड टेक? सर, देयर इज नॉट एनी प्रिसाइज अमाउंट वी शुड कंसीडर व्हाइल टेकिंग इट.
प्रिसाइज अमाउंट, देखो, दिस इज द प्लानिंग पार्ट, ठीक है ना.
एज अ बी sir, I mean, how much we should extend, we should on which factor we should depend the amount of extension?
If it coming around 4.2 means it is crossing 4, okay. So crossing 4, so you can take 5 next integer. Okay, don't take like it is coming greater than 4, so you are taking 7. Okay, one integer above that, just round off that. Okay. But you can take 4 also, but that will be a very congested system. But depending on the situation only, you have to use for this 2 hours only and for 4 hours for this system. Okay? Take some extension if you need extra power. Okay? So just take one upper, more than that, maximum. Because increasing panels, the overall cost will increase. Now what will be the size of the inverter? So inverter size should be what? 25 to 30% of your load that you are connecting to the PV system. 25 to 30% you should normally take, considering the losses and all.
Sir, if I am taking 30%, then it is 327.6.
327.6.
30% I have considered.
You have 30%. 30% of what you have considered?
Sir, hello? Load.
30% of what? Load is what? How much load is there? 75 plus 18.
Sorry, total load is 1092 watt hours per day.
That is not load, that is the energy. What is the load? Total load. What total watt of the appliances? Load power is different and energy is different.
Consumption okay. Kitna ho raha hai, ye batao.
Consumption, what is the consumption? What is the watt? See, one appliance you have taken CFL. So CFL is of 18 watt. Plus second is the fan, which is of 60 watt. And the third one is
55.9. So total will be 143 watt unload.
153 watt. Okay.
143, sir.
153. No, sir. 153,
yes, sir.
153.
Sir, actually I have no calculator. I am calculating with my hand, so
it's no, कोई बात. चलो अभी से आ गया, इसका 25 to 30% कितना हो गया?
सर 30% will be 45.9.
मतलब इसमें जोड़ दो तो कितना हो जाएगा? इससे ज़्यादा लेना है 35%, मतलब you have to take 35% more than this. मतलब 153 plus मतलब वही 200 के आसपास, ठीक है?
Yes sir, it is coming 198.9.
200
sir. Yes sir, 200.
So, तो हम लोग को अब क्या चाहिए? अब इसकी यूनिट, अब देखो सबसे पहले इन्वर्टर की यूनिट होती है वोल्ट एम्पियर में, ठीक है?
Yes.
तो हम लोग का कितना हो जाएगा? 200 वोल्ट एम्पियर हम लोग को इन्वर्टर की रिक्वायरमेंट होगी इसमें, ठीक है? All of you got it? Now the fourth part is battery sizing. अब बैटरी साइजिंग करो कितना? What is the battery capacity required in a day, in a particular day? For a 12 volt battery.
Sir, we have to divide total energy required by 12.
Energy required by total watt hour required by the appliances divided by efficiency into depth of discharge into voltage. ये सब डिवाइड में रहेगा, जो मल्टीप्लाई वाला पार्ट है सब डिवाइड में रहेगा, ठीक है? तो एफिशिएंसी ले लो तुम लोग 0.85, ठीक है? 85%, डेप्थ ऑफ डिस्चार्ज ले लो 60%, और बैटरी वोल्टेज पता ही तुम लोग को 12 वोल्ट।
यस सर।
What is the that unit of the battery capacity?
Sir, what?
What?
Battery voltage, sir, voltage.
Voltage?
Battery capacity, sir, voltage में होगा.
Battery capacity voltage में होगा. Battery capacity अपनी mobile की battery capacity किसमें होती है?
Oh, volt ampere.
Volt ampere ना? तो बैटरी कैपेसिटी तुम लोग बोलते हो ना, इतना कितने का पावर बैंक होता है? क्या बोलते हो, 10,000 क्या बोलते हो तुम लोग?
एमएच।
हाँ, तो एएच है, एएच क्या होता है? एमए क्या होता है? एम्पियर आवर।
मिली एम्पियर आवर।
क्या होगा एम्पियर?
हाँ सर, यहाँ पर एम्पियर आवर होगा, तो
एम्पियर होगा नहीं तो कैलकुलेट करके देख लो, एम्पियर आवर है, ठीक है ना? तो बैटरी कैपेसिटी जो एक दिन की आएगी वो कितनी आएगी? 178 एम्पियर आवर, ओके? तो अब क्या होता है, बैटरी कैपेसिटी एक्चुअली हम लोग को कितने दिन के लिए लेनी होती है? मिनिमम फॉर टू और थ्री डेज, या थ्री या फोर डेज, तो टोटल बैटरी कैपेसिटी कितनी आ जाएगी रिक्वायर्ड, 178 इंटू 3 विच इज कमिंग अराउंड 534. Got it all of you? एक बार हाँ तो बोल दो यार सब लोग.
Yes sir.
और एक पुलिस
वाला. अरे क्या यार ये लोग.
और सब कहाँ हैं, सो रहे हैं क्या?
सर के ऊपर से जा रहा है तो बताओ. Then we will leave the session. I am asking to all of you. If you are getting monotonous, please tell us. We will just close the session. Roughly 2-3 numericals you just give Akshit to them. They will have the practice by themselves. And by solving that, they will get the rough idea regarding all these things.
I hope the battery capacity, haan, ma'am. The battery capacity is the last part. So the total ampere hour kitna aa raha hai? Koi to jawab do.
535.29 for 3 days.
For 3 days? 535.29? अब हम लोग देखो, तुम लोग मार्केट में जाओगे देखने के लिए 539.29 की तो नहीं मिलेगी, ठीक है? ऐसी मिलती है, वो भी 500 की मिलेगी, नहीं तो 600 की मिलेगी, 800 की मिलेगी, ठीक है? तो हम लोग क्या है, तो अब डिपेंडिंग ऑन जो भी अब नेक्स्ट तुमको जो मिलेगा, तो जैसे 600 एम्पियर आवर की आती है, 750 एम्पियर आवर की आती है बैटरी, तो यू कैन सेलेक्ट दैट बैटरी ऑल्सो, ठीक है ना? इससे ज़्यादा ही की लेना, मतलब रिक्वायर होगी. तो यहाँ पे बस एक ये छोटा सा पार्ट था. सो दैट वाज अबाउट द डिजाइनिंग पार्ट, सोलर पीवी डिजाइन पार्ट. नाउ यू हैव टू कंसीडर द कॉस्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम आल्सो. इफ यू आर रेडी फॉर द कॉस्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम आई कैन टेल यू राइट नाउ, नहीं तो फिर तुम लोग देख लेना अपना कॉस्ट वाला पार्ट.
यस सर, हाउ टू फाइंड द कॉस्ट सर?
कॉस्ट देखो ना, क्या क्या तुम्हारा यूज हो रहा है सिस्टम में, क्या क्या यूज हो रहा है.
सर सीएफएल फैन और रेफ्रिजरेटर.
अरे सीएफएल फैन तो तुम्हारा घर का है यार, उसका क्यों इंक्लूड कर रहे हो इसमें? अब उसको तुम फिर से खरीदोगे नया क्या, जो तो घर में लगा ही हुआ है ना पहले से.
यस सर.
अभी सिस्टम बनाने के लिए क्या क्या यूज़ हो रहा है?
इन्वर्टर,
पीवी मॉड्यूल
और पैनल.
हाँ पैनल लगेगा, बैटरी लगेगी, और इन्वर्टर लगेगा, ठीक है? मतलब बेसिक जो तीन चीज़ें हैं. तो जो तुम्हारा पीवी मॉड्यूल का कॉस्ट होता है, एक तुम्हारा कितना हो गए 200 रुपीज़ पर वॉट मान लो, ठीक है?
यस सर.
कंसीडर कर लो 200 वॉट पर 200 रुपीज़ पर वॉट पीवी मॉड्यूल के लिए, ठीक है?
यस सर.
बैटरी का तुम लोग नेट पे देख लेना है, बैटरी कितना 600 एम्पियर आवर की कितने की आएगी या 500 एम्पियर आवर की, ठीक है? वो बैटरी भी तुमको पता ही है कितनी बैटरी लगी है, उससे मल्टीप्लाई कर दोगे, ठीक?
यस सर.
इन्वर्टर का ही वैसे ही है, इन्वर्टर भी तुम्हारा वोल्ट एम्पियर का है, तो उसकी भी कॉस्ट तुम लोग नेट पे देख लो. अलग अलग कॉस्टिंग है, देखो सबकी अलग अलग कंपनी की अलग अलग होती है, ठीक है ना? डिपेंड अपन तुम्हारा कितना वो है, कितना लगाना है. अच्छे अच्छे इन्वर्टर्स भी आते हैं जो कॉस्टली भी रहते हैं, नॉर्मल भी आते हैं जो इंडियन यूजेज के लिए है.
अकॉर्डिंग टू योर रिक्वायरमेंट यू हैव टू चूज.
ये बस एक प्लानिंग स्टेज है, ओके? सो इफ यू वांट टू गेट डीप इनटू दिस, तो बहुत कुछ टेक्निकल इम्प्लीकेशंस होती हैं व्हाइल कनेक्टिंग अ सिस्टम, बहुत कुछ. देखो एक पीवी सिस्टम इज नॉट एक्चुअली ए सिस्टम वेयर यू आर कन्वर्टिंग डीसी इनटू एसी. देयर आर नंबर ऑफ थिंग्स, कंट्रोल सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो देयर, नेटवर्क्स इज ऑल्सो देयर, पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इज ऑल्सो देयर, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पावर सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो देयर, everything is there. It is not a simple concept. It is a amalgamation of different type of concept that you are studying in your BTech exam. This is an extension of your, this is an application of all your subjects that you are using. Microprocessors also are being used in this. Digital control is also used in this. The knowledge of computer programming is also important. You cannot always calculate by your hands. You have to frame a program by where you can change your values and you can design system on an ease.
So that session, section we will discuss later on, Akshit, I think so.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, because it's a very big area.
Yes, ma'am, it is a very big area.
You can't deal with all of them. So till this part it is okay for them. Let they have the costing regarding solar panels and all these things. During the day-to-day work style, how many panels we have to use to recover all these things. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. And they have to, they should, they can also, ma'am, do for their home also. The number of PV requirement is there.
Yes, yes, yes.
They can check also, ma'am, in latest technologies or what the government are supporting. Having a knowledge of these only, ma'am, can help in that long term if you are going in this profile. Electrical. So any questions, anybody? If you have any question, you can ask.
Any question from your side? Please ask Akshit, or even you can ask to me also. Nishant, are you there? So they are telling there is no question.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So Akshit, so you are, we think now we have to wrap up this session. Nishant?
Yes, ma'am.
So let me talk to the participants for 2 minutes. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I'm asking to all of you, have you enjoyed the session? Tell the correct thing. There is no need to say yes, ma'am, and yes, ma'am. What are the modifications you wanted in this session? Have you learned something? 8% bhi sikha hoga, then it is fruitful for us. Otherwise, it's useless. I'm asking to all of you. First one which is coming on the screen is Chandradeep. Chandradeep, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Kuch sikha aapne? Have you learned something from these sessions?
Yes, ma'am.
Was it interesting?
Costing of battery, inverter, AA module.
Was it interesting for all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
So kindly give the feedback. Nishan, just circulate a
yes,
Google
ma'am.
Feedback. Just circulate a Google feedback system, okay? And all of you
okay,
are
ma'am.
Free to fill it up. It's not necessary that you have to write only the positive things. The negative comments you are always is always welcomed by me. Okay. Then Divya Jyoti is there. Divya Jyoti. No, he is not responding. Pallavi? Hello, Pallavi? Achha, all of them are muted. Let the, unmute karo Nishant unko thoda. Unmute them. Pallavi, are you listening me? Yeah.
They have the access to unmute themselves.
Okay, but all of them are muted. They are not listening to me, I think so. Palvi is not responding. Then Jiaul Haq is there.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Tell something. I think now all of them are tired. Okay. So fine. With these words, I am wrapping up this session. And before closing this, definitely I would like to thank and put my regards to Dr. R. Roy, sir, Director of Chaibasa Engineering College, for giving me this opportunity to conduct this session named Energy Harvesting in Recent Scenario, the burning topic of today's era. Thank you, sir. And I also would like to thank head of the department, electrical engineering, Mr. Subhadeep Pan, to organize such a nice webinar, which is definitely the need of the hour in this pandemic. Okay. And also I would like to thank my both scholars, Akshit and Nishant. Without the help of them, the session could not be completed smoothly. And really, really, I am thankful to them as they are always available in the ups and downs of my life. Okay. So thanks, Akshit and Nishant. And last but not the least, thanks to the students, all of you, who listened the entire session patiently. That is the toughest part of our life. With these words, again, I am thanking all of you. And hopefully, we will meet very soon in your institute. With this hope, I am just closing this session. Again, thanks to all of you. Okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, Nishant?
Yes, ma'am. From.
Okay. Akshit? Okay, Nishant? Just I'm leaving the meeting.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, I thanks all of you.
Thank you, ma'am. From.
Yeah, thank students. You,
thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.